On January 29th, following a solemn funeral mass at St. Volodymyr Cathedral in KU, the remains of Ukrainian poet and political leader Oleksandr Oles Kandyba and his wife Vera Kandyba were reburied at Lukyanivske Cemetery in KU. This repatriation of the remains of Oles and his wife had been an unexpected turn of events. Oleksandr Oles was a popular poet in the first half of the 20th century. He was a notable representative of the interwar Ukrainian emigre community. Oles was also the father of Oleg Olzhich, the prominent poet and leader of the Ukrainian nationalist anti-Nazi resistance during the Second World War. Olzhich, as many Ukrainians know, was tortured to death in a Nazi concentration camp. Oleksandr Oles left Ukraine in 1919, following the failure of the Ukrainian struggle for independence. He died in 1944 in Prague and was buried there at Olshane Cemetery.
Поет української державності. Він оспівав першу українську народну республіку. Його син продовжив лінію батька. Це великий український націоналіст Ольжич, який загинув у німецькій гестапівській тюрмі.
Until recently, there were no indications that Oleksandr Oles' final resting place would need to change. However, on January 3rd, his coffin was exhumed and the future of his remains were placed in doubt. In accordance with Czech law, after a person is buried, the relatives or friends of the deceased need to pay rent in order to maintain a place for the deceased in the cemetery. For many decades, the rent for Oleksandr Oles' burial place had been voluntarily paid by a Ukrainian emigre activist in Prague, an admirer of Oles' poetry, Volodymyr Mikhailishin. But when Mikhailishin passed away recently, his son decided to bury his father in Oles' grave, and so the coffins of Oles and his wife were removed. This caused a great deal of commotion in Ukraine and in the Ukrainian diaspora. Eventually, the Ukrainian government reached an agreement with the Czech authorities to transfer the coffins of Oles and his wife to Ukraine for reburial. The reburial ceremony in KU was attended by numerous visitors, including state dignitaries and contemporary admirers of Oles' poetry.
Сміються, плачуть солов'ї і б'ють піснями в груди.
Тоді не треба плачу, коли іде боротьба за волю, за життя. Коли на хмарах я вже дивний відблиск бачу, і сонця жданого блискуче вороття.
This entire incident relating to Oleksandr Oles drew attention of Ukrainians to a broader problem. As the older generations of the Ukrainian diaspora slowly pass away, many other burial places of prominent Ukrainian historical figures who died and were buried abroad are at risk of ending up in a similar state of uncertainty. In order to avoid such problems in the future, the Ukrainian authorities have begun to develop a strategy for the preservation of these burial places. In some cases, the Ukrainian authorities will help Ukrainian diaspora communities take care of the graves of well-known Ukrainian political and cultural leaders in the West. In other cases, some of the most prominent individuals will be reburied in Ukraine.
Якщо втрачається контроль родичів, які дбають про могили, або держава там активно долучається, або ми домовляємося з тими країнами, з громадами, щоб ті особи були перепоховані тут в Україні.
A special memorial avenue has been designated for this purpose at the Lukyanivske Cemetery in KU. I'm Tanya Stech. And this was Ukraine in the News.
Канал 1+1 тепер доступний на Bell International Programming.